The last two nights, we've told you about allegations of physical abuse made by former high-ranking members of the Church of Scientology against the church's leader, David Miscavige. Now, the church not only denies all those allegations, but says they come from people who are working together to destroy the church. And the church says one of the people making allegations was demoted and then removed from his senior position precisely because he was violent. Well, tonight, how even the competing versions of what happened ultimately raised questions that the public's entitled to know. What was going on in the church? And why were the police never called to investigate?
In late 03, there was a beating every day. And if it wasn't him doing it, it was from him inciting others to do it to others.
In front of other people.
In front of other people.
Since first coming forward last year in the St. Petersburg Times with allegations of abuse against church leader David Miscavige, Marty Rathbun and five other former high-ranking Scientologists have found themselves under vigorous attack by the church they once dedicated their lives to. The former Scientologists are accused of working together to destroy the church. Tommy Davis is the church spokesman.
The church is going to defend itself. It's going to defend itself for its own sake, and it's going to defend itself for the sake of its parishioners. And the fact of the matter is these individuals are out there, and they're lying.
Current and former senior Scientologists sent CNN dozens of declarations, emails, and affidavits defending the church and its leader and attacking the credibility of those who've spoken out.
Thank you very much.
The church says former construction manager Tom DeVocht was violent and wasted millions of church dollars during his time in the C organization, the church's religious order. They allege former spokesman Mike Rinder physically attacked his subordinates and say former marketing manager Jeff Hawkins has attended rallies with an anti-Scientology movement called Anonymous, which protests against the church. Most of the church's affidavits specifically name Marty Rathbun, whom they say assaulted members of the C organization on numerous occasions.
The affidavits are from people who said within the church, who said that the beatings and the physical abuse was not perpetrated by David Miscavige, but was perpetrated by you.
Right. Outright lies. I did some, and I didn't come in here ever telling you I was the Lord Fauntleroy and never did anything wrong. I'm no angel. I'm going to tell you, I was involved in this. But for God's sake, to try to make it sound like I perpetuated the whole thing is just a complete and utter fabrication.
In sworn affidavits, a number of church members make specific allegations against Marty Rathbun, including more than a dozen instances of physical violence. One person writes she witnessed Rathbun hitting a colleague, quote, about the head and in the face while yelling at him. Another writes Rathbun, quote, walked into the office and appeared upset with me, adding he suddenly punched me in the stomach. And his own ex-wife says Marty Rathbun lives for war.
People, many of them who you know very well, they all say David Miscavige is kind. They say he's hardworking, that he's a passionate man who's done really nothing but good for the church.
They will say anything they need to say, Anderson.
Current senior members of the C organization say that while their former colleague Marty Rathbun was repeatedly violent, for many years, none of them informed the church's leader, David Miscavige.
That guy had the streak of violence.
Right. Four occasions between 2000 and 2002 to you, Mr. Starkey, as well as at least five incidents in 2001. So that's nine incidents between 2000 and 2002.
Yeah,
the bottom
that's
line is Marty Rathbun is gone. When it was found out, he's out of the church.
So no one can answer me why David Miscavige was not informed for several years.
I absolutely can answer you. Mr. Miscavige was not there.
He was not there, but there are telephones, you have fax machines, you have emails.
Yeah,
when somebody
blows up like a Marty Rathbun or commits something, you don't immediately pick up the phone and call the leader of a worldwide religion.
Well, you have 4 years to do it here. So no one over the course of 4 years informed David Miscavige that a high-ranking member
like
of his church...
No, we have plus you have there's something you don't understand.
You can Marty say yes Rathbun, and no. No, I'm just asking.
Marty Rathbun was not in a top position when that happened at all. He was and you know,
he was a member of the C organization. He was important enough to have an office next to you. Nobody informed David Miscavige this was going on.
The point is that when Mr. Miscavige was informed, Marty was removed. That's what matters.
There's no physical evidence proving the former Scientologist's charges, just as the affidavits supporting Miscavige and attacking his critics also cannot be verified. But surprisingly, though they disagree on who was perpetrating it, both sides describe a work environment inside the church where punching, choking, and kicking as a means of discipline and intimidation occurred on numerous occasions, and no one ever filed criminal charges or even called the police.
Tommy Davis is the church spokesman, and Monique Yingling is an attorney for the church.
How is it possible that a member of the church could assault about a dozen people and nobody come forward about it and nobody file any charges? How come the church didn't file any charges if, in fact, Marty Rathbun was really beating people up?
People did come forward about it, and there were reports written, as Mr. Davis pointed out. And the reason that there were reports written was because it was very untoward. There may have been some people who decided they didn't want to report it, and they suffered it in silence. But there were indeed reports written.
So why didn't the church then decide to proceed with charges? I mean, aggravated assault is a felony. It's against the law.
The church treated it as an internal matter, and he was disciplined internally.
I'm trying to understand, you've said that Marty Rathbun beat people more than a dozen times or so. You said Mike Rinder has beat people, and that was known apparently at the time, at least some of it was known at the time, and yet that seemed to be acceptable behavior in the church. I mean, that no charges were ever filed against any of these people.
Well,
seems
they were
remarkable to me, if in fact that is really the truth, unless the opposite is true and their charges are true, and it was the head of the church who was doing these beatings, in which case it would make sense that no charge would be filed or no one would come forward.
Well, they were removed. The point is that they were removed. The choice of the individuals who were attacked on whether to file charges or not was completely their choice.
But if this is so abhorrent to Scientology's beliefs, beatings, why then it doesn't seem that it was taken all that seriously?
Oh, it absolutely was.
Oh, I think it was taken very, very seriously.
I mean,
if my boss is started to beat me up here and the head of Time Warner said, oh, well, you know, we're going to deal with it as an internal matter, I mean, I think that would be pretty shocking.
Here's the thing. The point is that when it was discovered, he was disciplined and he was removed.
Well, David Miscavige, the chairman of the board of Scientology, rarely meets the media. He's not done a news interview since 1998. We've offered many times for Mr. Miscavige to appear on 360 for the series, but his spokesman, Tommy Davis, has declined for Mr. Miscavige. Our invitation is still open. We'd love to have him on the program.